You were part of the Brotherhood of Breath anthem by Chris McGregor as well.
Yeah, late arrival.
It was quite an important thing on the British death scene at the time.
Oh yeah, lovely band. I wish I'd done more with them, but I came in quite late.
Yeah. Did you tour a lot in Europe and stuff?
No, I didn't do much. I think probably I did about 20 gigs at the most. And then I wasn't on the record anyway, but then after Chris had died, we had the Dedication Orchestra with lots of the same people. So I was in that, and I'm on the two albums.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the Melody 4 and the sort of stuff you did in the 80s, and starting from the 80s. It seems quite different from your previous work, sort of partly return to the tradition of songs and stuff.
Yeah, it's just I was working with a theatre group when I met Dave Holland, not the bass player, Pins. Dave Holland was the musical director of this theatre group, Welfare State, that I worked with when I joined them. And I just worked more and more with him, and we both left the state and formed this thing called the Johnny Rondo Trio with a cellist, Colin Wood, who was also an improviser. In fact, I knew him first as an improviser, I think. Yeah, it just came out of that. But there was a lot of improvising in it anyway. I mean, we did play tunes and a few songs, but the situation was very shaky. We never did a programme. I mean, when anything could happen on a gig, it would go off at a tangent at any time. It was guaranteed to.
So it's necessary that you have a lot of repertoire in common between you.
Yeah, and we wrote things as well.
Mm-hmm.
But virtually everything I've ever done has had an element of improvisation in it, either free improvisation or on the chord structure. I've always wanted that to be there. But it doesn't mean that if someone asks me to play in a dance band for a party or something, I'd probably say yes and just go and play it straight for the sake of doing it. But really, really I like music that involves me improvising, and everybody else as well.
How different is the viewer with Steve from the Melody form?
Not very different. No, it's not really. It's just me and Tony not here. Sometimes we call ourselves the Melody 5. So if ever we can't make a gig at all, we'll probably be an orchestra.
And how long have you actually been doing it as a duo?
Ever since the first gig that Tony couldn't do.
Yeah.
I knew Tony, but not really very well. But I was friendly with Steve probably 10 years before I was friendly with Tony.
Uh-huh.
Although I did know him, and I loved his play.
He's from Canterbury, actually.
Yeah, so he's bass player.
How would you describe your musical environment in the 90s now? How do you sense the musical environment?
Same as before, except I don't have any specific ongoing ties. Most of my stuff is improvisationally based anyway, as it always was virtually. With the Johnny Rondo Trio, the tunes were more predominant. Nevertheless, though, someone could always go off at a tangent and destroy a tune. But most of the things I do now are improvised. Melody 4 is kind of like the same approach as the Johnny Rondo Trio, except we do actually call certain tunes that we know we're going to play, but we don't necessarily know how we're going to play them. So it's always changing, you know. I never like to know exactly what's going to happen.
What are your main gigs at the moment?
Mostly improvising in London. I don't go away very much. I still do solos, but usually as part of an overall thing. There's so many good improvisers in London, and I'm deeply involved in that. Or open things where people can come in. But people like Elton, for instance, are still involved. You know, I still play with him sometimes through that. Mm-hmm. People re-emerge, you know.
How's the circuit music in Europe?
I think it's a bad time at the moment. Yeah. I was never one of the main people getting all these things, but I did have quite a good lot of stuff. But it's quite difficult. It's all a money thing, you know. I mean, they don't have the money in Europe to bring so many of the English players over.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all it's down to. Same in England. And we have people come over from Europe to stay in someone's house and play and hope they get something more than the fare, you know. And the other way around, you know, we just kind of try to keep playing.
What are your memories of playing on the pop rock circuit with Kevin Ayers? Was it really a lot different? you know, playing to festival audiences, young people on dope and stuff. Wild.
Well, yes, but that's it. No, it wasn't a wild experience. No, there were more people. There were more people. 5,000 people are more than 20. Uh-huh. I can't think of any. That didn't really matter very much. It was the playing, and that's it. I mean,
that was a crazy band, though. The Whole World.
Yeah, it was a good band. I liked it very much.
Really,
yeah.
Unpredictable.
Yeah, yeah. And that ties in with all the other things. I mean, playing with them is like playing with Steve. It's different music, but the same thing is there. You know, you set out, you have some idea of what you're going to do. Whether you do it or not, it's a different matter.